he's just been playing him ever since. His results have also been pretty good for someone who's just picked up a new character like that. Alright, so we're going to get into game one on PS2, probably just a gentleman. I don't really see this being a very strong advantage for either character in this matchup. But we see a couple neutral exchanges. Diddy Kong getting a lot more off of his combos than Sora. But as the meta develops, we may see more stuff from Sora landing and falling there, because the stuff I've seen in training mode is a bit ridiculous, and Zoo particularly is capable of doing that stuff every once in a while.
Zoo has some of the best strings we've seen out of low percent combos for Sora, that like for a lot of people on the come up right now. And one of the things that Diddy Kong is so good at, we've joked about this so many times before, but it's the truth, banana beats Sora.
Yeah.
And that Sora being a very different type of sortie because of how floaty he is, it's a lot easier for him to navigate around the banana mix-ups by comparison to a lot of other sorties who want to short hop pressure you a lot. He goes everywhere, and that's what we're seeing a couple Sonic Blade mix-ups too, because he's kind of catching Nelvin off guard where he tries to maybe go for the banana pick, and it's actually working pretty well. Granted, he's behind a percent right now, but let's see how the ledge traps in particular. I think that's where Nelvin's going to win the set if he wants to win.
I think another big thing that helps Sora in neutral against Diddy Kong is that Diddy Kong has a much harder time getting banana punishes off of floatier characters, because hitting a banana in the air just is not as impactful as hitting a banana on the ground. That doesn't matter if you get up smashed.
Exactly.
Sora is one of the lightest characters in the game. That's going to kill him at 90.
Yeah, see, this is where that issue with Diddy Kong not having the ability to KO consistently comes in clutch, because now you have a character who's super light. But catching him at the ledge over and over again is going to also be a huge thing to get that damage on. At least for Sora, though, when it comes to Zoo, he has the ability to get straight hit KO potentials pretty easy. One good up air, or even one good backer, which you saw him kind of hunting for at ledge before, we'll get it. But a big whiff punish here in the up smash will take it out.
I think most of the places Diddy Kong is going to get kills in this matchup are going to be ledge trapping, because there are certain places where Sora effectively does not have access to a double jump, and being on the ledge is one of them just because of how slowly he accelerates, and in random kills out of shield. Diddy Kong has a frame 5 up smash out of shield, and if Sora lands the wrong way on it, he's just going to die.
Yeah, exactly. And like, Sora has the ability to punish you for overextending really well. That's something we've seen out in his character. Not only with trying to falling in with the single hit, like double nair into down tilt strings, but down tilt in general is so strong because it leads to the follow up up air or that up smash. And now you're seeing slowly, like, you see the way Zeus kind of just like putting option coverage out there. Like, I'm putting these big hitboxes out so you don't monkey flip. That way I can run up on you for free.
We're also starting to get to the percent where the confirm of double nair into up air is going to start King Diddy Kong.
True.
Like, double nair is always the thing you want most to avoid against Sora, because at low percents he gets crazy combos, he can even move you, and at high percents he can just kill you off of an up air or an up smash. That being said, Diddy Kong banana, once again, just going to take the stock.
Simplify the game. Use your win condition. You have that banana. Make sure you continuously just slow them down. I don't agree with that one so much.
He's playing with fire here. That's how he lost his first stock, and that's how he's going to lose his second stock. That up throw shouldn't even have killed. He just wasn't ready for it.
Who's going to save the world? What are you doing? So giving up a free one right there, up being at him, looking for something big, but not getting anything out of it because of it. And now this monkey flip going to push him off to the left-hand side here. Get some damage on.
Just getting out of that ledge trap. And Diddy Kong having to pick up the banana to throw it just prevented him from getting any sort of punishment. But that upbeat hitbox is massive. Landing on the platform buff sword in a place where he can't even punish it effectively is still enough to get him a hitbox.
Yeah, now you see, like, Zoo just trying to catch him on being a little bit too aggressive on landing, hopefully to find a big opener. These Sonic Blades going to come in, put him straight to 70. He reverses the ledge.
That up smash.
That might have killed.
Yeah. No, it definitely would have killed.
Like, that was, like, right at sweet spot range, too. So,
yeah.
Oh, catches him with the up smash on the platform. That's going to be Nelvin finding a mistake, finally out of Zoo in that spot, taking it out. But he did a good job of controlling the pace of the game for a majority of it. Just ended up, like, it got close at the end. That was, like, literal frames off of being Zoo's game.
Diddy Kong's up smash goes surprisingly high up. Like, it makes sense when you're standing on a platform in Battlefield or small Battlefield and you get hit by the last hit, because the hand firmly goes through the platform and hits you. But on PS2, a stage with some of the highest intermediary platforms of the game, you still get hit by the last hit of that up smash. That's kind of crazy. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Zoo just didn't expect to get hit there because it didn't look like it would have reached.
Maybe. That might be a big part of it. Let's see how he adjusts here on Smash. So Diddy Kong wants to force you to get to ledge traps as quick as possible. So this still works for Nelvin. But what in your mind is behind the idea of why Zoo decided to go here to Smash Bros.?
I think maybe he's having a hard time catching this squirmy little monkey. He's just, he can run so fast away from Sora just because Sora is so slow relative to Diddy Kong that he can just, if he's not feeling comfortable in the situation, he can leave with a monkey flip and just by dashing away, grab a banana, and then re-engage when he thinks that things are more comfortable for him. Limiting the amount of stage he has to run around on greatly benefits Sora in this regard when it comes to catching the monkey. But at the same time, Sora doesn't have that great frame data, and that can really hurt him when it comes to boxing with Diddy Kong. Because if Diddy Kong rushes you down, it's very hard to deal with it if you don't have the fast hitboxes to try to call out his options.
Yeah, I mean, so far, at least, like, he's been able to hold a decent lead. Back throw, not enough, even here on Smashville, to not take it off the side. But big whiff punisher, yeah, back throw, rinse repeat, send them right back out.
That will do it. Any number of options could have killed there. Zoot going for the tried and true method. No way that would not work.
Simplicity is key. So yeah. It's not worth it to try and go for like the big hit sometimes. Just like, oh, you all right, you just put yourself in front of me. Now he needs to cash in on big reward on the low percent. We saw Nelvin got a lot of command grabs off of monkey flip between the last game and this one. We're gonna see a lot more kicks as he catches him whipping some aerials right there. That's worth taking the trade.
Okay, so Diddy Kong can hit the Smashville platform too. His hands are enormous. All right, if I'm on a platform, I'm gonna assume that Diddy Kong's gonna try to up smash me. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's so scary. It's so frightening to deal with in that position. Like, both these characters are so good at just kind of smothering you on that platform, continuously making you feel like you have nowhere to go. And it's working well. I like these Fire Rangas to kind of check the monkey flips, though.
I love Zoo's neutral Bs in general. He's using them really, really well in order to control his position in such a way that he can safely do them and cover himself. Like, when he goes to ledge, he'll often B-reverse the neutral Bs as well as stall himself in the air with them in order to make sure that Diddy Kong just can't challenge him when he's trying to come back.
Yeah, and Diddy Kong is always looking for that one option out of you on landing. Did you air dodge or did you decide to swing at a disadvantage? Well, with those neutral Bs, you could stop that. Right now, though, at 64%, you have to watch out for potential nair into down air.
Oh.
I actually like that. He does, like that. Sometimes I don't agree with that, but that one was actually pretty good because he hasn't gone for that for a while. But reverse Thundaga is going to get him the KO off
that's
the side.
That's exactly one of the neutral Bs I was talking about, and that's why Nelvin hasn't been so eager to try to catch him off stage. Just by stalling himself in the air and turning around the Thundaga, he was able to turn a situation where he looked like he was about to die and continue to kill him. But once again, that banana is just going to give him that up smash, and that's the primary way that Nelvin is taking these stocks. And it seems to be working out really, really well for him.
Yeah.
Because Sora is so light, you just need to land one at like 90%, and that's going to be it.
You already know it's that time. It's in that situation where Nelvin's at his best. Nelvin loves being in this spot because he capitalizes on people who overextend so well in this spot. Much like that Sonic Blade, you should have just went to the left, but he decided to go at him to try and mix him up. And now he's at 59%. Dash deck does get an opening. Big punish there. The aggressive up B, though, he's like, he's not afraid to challenge you. He doesn't want you to steal that momentum. He will go fight you.
Yeah. This is actually the most up B I've seen from Nelvin in any of the other sets I've seen of him.
Oh, big whip! Yeah, catch him on the roll, and Force Smash will take it. I did not think for a second, like, that was under 100%, too. I did not think that was going to take out for a second there.
Realistically, though, that game was last stock, last hit for both players. Because Diddy Kong was in the range for a down tilt up smash.